ఇంటర్మీడియట్ విద్యా రంగంలో అగ్రగామి మన ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ఐఐటి జేఈఈ అయినా నీట్ అయినా తిరుగులేని విద్యా సంస్థ ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్
నౌ వి ఆర్ ఇన్ ద డిస్కషన్ అబౌట్ ద ప్రాసెస్ కాల్డ్ ఆస్మోసిస్ ఆస్మోసిస్ వి డిస్కస్డ్ విత్ ద ఎక్స్పెరిమెంట్స్ కాల్డ్ డిస్టిల్ ఫనల్ ఎక్స్పెరిమెంట్ ఇన్ డిస్టిల్ ఫనల్ ఎక్స్పెరిమెంట్ వి డిస్కస్ దట్ In distilled funnel, we have taken sucrose solution. In the beaker, we have taken water. So water flows across the semi-permeable member into distilled funnel. When pressure is applied on the distilled funnel, again sucrose solution comes back to the water until it reaches the state called equilibrium. So we discussed distilled funnel experiment for the last class. Now let us talk about osmosis. Let's continue with osmosis. Let us take two cells. The two chambers. Let us take chamber A. It's connected with chamber B with semi-permeable membrane. With semi-permeable membrane. Okay. So what you can see here, we have taken two chambers. Chamber A, it's connected with chamber B with the help of semi-permeable membrane. So flow occurs through semi-permeable membrane itself is called osmosis, right? Now you can see a small molecules here, very few solute molecules are there here. So let us say here a few solute molecules. Let us take in the first chamber. In chamber A, we find few solute molecules. Now in chamber B, let us take more solute molecules. Imagine there are many solute molecules here. So there are many or more solute molecules. So here you find more solute molecules. Right. So here, first chamber has few solute molecules dissolved in water. Okay, dissolved in water, and this is what water is there. I'm not drawing the water because I just want to show the solute molecules. In second chamber, you find more solute molecules got dissolved. So if you look at the scenario here, there is a movement happening here. So where what do you find here? When you find here, high water potential, because high water is there but low solute concentration. What you find here? Low solute concentration, because you find more water is there but few solute molecules are there here. Few solute molecules are there here and more water is there. When you find more water in the first chamber, you find high water potential. And what is the concentration of the solute? You see, low solute concentration. I hope it's clear about first chamber. I say again, in the first chamber, few solute molecules are dissolved in more water. More water means higher water potential and low solute concentration. Coming to the next one, more solute concentration is there. So you find more or high solute concentration. High solute concentration but low water potential, lower water potential. Why? Because more is the water, more is the water potential. Lower is the water content, low will be the water potential. So here, if taken both chambers, both chambers are connected with semi-permeable membrane. Then now the movement happens from where to where? So here, what is the direction of osmosis? What is the net direction of osmosis? So from where to where the solution or the water is moving here? Net direction of osmosis. Obviously, what you can tell me? Guys, can you tell me where to where the movement occurs? It occurs from A to B. Why? So you know that always, let us take the movement, always the movement occurs from higher water potential to lower water potential. Lower water potential. Always the movement is occurring from where to where? So the movement of the solution or water occurs from higher water potential to lower water potential. Where do you find higher water potential? Here this chamber has higher water potential, that is net direction of osmosis from A to B, because A has higher water potential and B has lower water potential. Suppose this is given in the question and diagram is given in the question, because most of the times the question will be asked like this. A chamber, few solute molecules. B chamber, more solute molecules. Now let us answer the questions based on the diagrams. Now see, let us see here. For example, they'll say that, I'm giving you the questions here. Which chamber has, this is a question, take down under note points, very important, take down under note points. Which chamber has, question number 1, let us take, high water potential, that is chi W. And second question may be, which chamber has high solute potential? That is IS. Third question is, which chamber has low water potential? I hope it's visible till here. Right. Till here, no, sir? Till here. Right. Now which one has lower water potential and which one has low solute potential? Right. Now answer the questions here. What is the first question? Now we have two chambers A and B. Now the question is, suppose if the question is, which chamber has high water potential? So that we can write very easily, because where you find few water molecules, few solute molecules, which can be answered easily, because here few solute molecules are there, automatically more water, then higher water potential. This can be answered directly from the diagram, because you have to note down these two things. You have to get these two things in your mind, right? So easy, right? Higher water potential you will write down for cell A. All right. Then we can also answer very easily one more question, that is, which chamber has, suppose if the question is, which chamber has low water potential? So when you say A is having higher water potential, obviously you will take B, because B contains lower water potential. Why low water potential? High solute concentration. More solute molecules are there. So here water concentration is less, that means lower water potential. So automatically we will write B. Right. Then let's come to high solute potential. Let us write high solute potential. Now which chamber has high solute potential? You know, most of the people will think, guys, can you answer? What is the answer for second question? High solute potential. That means most of the people will take the answer as, here solute is less. B chamber has solute is more. More solute is there. So automatically they will think that, okay, so B chamber has the more solute, so B chamber has high solute potential. If you take the B chamber as high solute potential, if you think it's because of high solute concentration, this is completely wrong. You will lose 5 marks. Generally, even though we say so many times, most of the people will confuse here. Right? Why it is wrong? Because solute potential is inversely proportional to solute concentration. Here in B chamber, you find more solute molecules. It does not mean that he had more solute potential. What is solute potential here? Ability to move solute molecules. Potentiality, ability to move solute molecules. If there are more solute molecules, the ability to move solute molecules in different direction, it decreases. Then how can you write here B? So guys, make sure that you remember, in this case you have to remember this is also A. Most of the people will get confusion here. So whenever the question is high solute potential, higher water potential, then you have to take A. Remember, this is very very important. Here solute concentration is high but solute potential decreases. Solute potential is different from solute concentration. Remember this very very clearly in your mind. I repeat again, solute potential is different from solute concentration. Solute concentration is more here. Then what is meant by solute potential? Potentiality means ability to move. It's surrounded by so many solute molecules. When concentration is higher, the ability to move from one place to for other place for a solute molecule decreases. It will get decreases. So the one which has high solute concentration will be the one which has low solute potential. So whenever you get the question, high solute potential means not B, you have to take chamber A. Similarly, low solute potential means ability to move here is less. Why we wrote A here? Here solute molecules are of few here. Ability to move solute potential is more. Solute molecules can move freely in all directions. So solute potential increases. Solute potential increases. Why? Because solute molecule potentiality, ability to move is more, higher, increases. Solute potential increases for chamber A. Then coming to chamber B, because of high solute concentration, ability to move from one place to other place decreases. What decreases here? Solute potential decreases. So which chamber has low solute potential means chamber B will come. Okay, now based on this you have to remember very very importantly. Again I am writing note points, very very important points, note down, very 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 important, very important, note down this. What are these note points here? Here I say water potential is inversely proportional to solute concentration. Yes or no? Water potential is inversely proportional to solute concentration. If more solute, less is the water potential. More solute, less is the water potential. Low solute, higher is the water potential. Similarly we can also take solute potential is also inversely proportional to solute concentration. So with this what you can understand, therefore water potential is directly proportional to solute potential. Very 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 important. The more is the solute concentration, less is the water potential. Less is the solute concentration, more is the solute potential. That means both water potential and solute potential, both of them are inversely proportional to solute concentration. That means water potential is directly proportional to solute potential. That is the reason why the chamber which has A, chamber A has high water potential means is the same chamber A also has high solute potential. Don't write B, you will lose marks. Okay, similarly the chamber which has low water potential B is also the chamber also has a low solute potential. Here you don't write A, you will lose marks. Remember B. Why? Because water potential is directly proportional to solute potential. That means water potential is inversely proportional to solute concentration. Similarly, solute potential is different from solute concentration. So here this also inversely proportional. Then both of them are water potential and solute potential. Both of them are directly proportional. And in the same thing, I'll ask you one more question. Here I'm writing the question. Chamber A, one chamber has water potential minus 2000 megapascals, and other chamber, let us take this is as one chamber, let us take some name, let us give something called one chamber called M. One chamber M has water potential minus 2000 megapascals. Other chamber, for our understanding, let us write N, has water potential minus 1000 megapascals. Guys, what is the question here? Question I am writing here. One more question I am giving you. One chamber M, let us give some name A and B or X and Y, Z and Y, whatever it may be. One chamber, let us take M, has water potential value is minus 2000 megapascals. And other chamber, let us take N, has water potential minus 1000 megapascals. Then the water movement occurs from where to where? The water movement occurs from where to where? If this is a question, you know, the movement always occurs from higher water potential to lower water potential. I'm just pressing the places where you have a lot of confusion, guys. So even though you remember this you will remember. Most of the people, they'll say, no, ma'am, I studied the whole concept. I studied NCERT, Telugu Academy. I know the whole concept, but I could not able to do some questions on the paper. Because there are some points here. Logically, you have to remember. When you practically apply, you have to be very, very careful. This statement, everybody will remember. Coming to the practical application. Now tell me, M has a higher water potential or N has a higher potential? You know, negative values if you take, lesser is a negative value, itself is a greater value. Bigger negative value, itself is a lower value. That is a logical thing. Yeah, that is a logic you have to remember in this case, right? So what you have to write here? So in this case you take higher water potential you find for N, that is minus 1000 megapascals, and lower water potential you find for M, that is nothing but minus 2000 megapascals. So where to where the movement occurs? The water movement occurs from higher water potential to lower water potential, that is from N to M. All right? So you know it well, right? So generally they'll confuse some people, not all. They study everything, I'm not blaming them, but the thing is, small logic they will miss. They'll study a lot, they will do a lot of hard work, they study with a lot of concentration, they work hard on the paper. With the small logic, they may miss the answer. Such kind of thing should not happen. That's why, for example, I'm giving you minus 2000 means it's not a greater value. Minus number, if it is a bigger number, having the lower value. The minus with smaller number is the bigger number, is the bigger value. If you remember that, that's more than enough, right? So what happens in this case? M has minus 2000 megapascals. It's a lower value, meaning lower water potential. lower water potential is M. N has water potential minus 1000 megapascals. Smaller number with a negative value is a bigger number. So N has higher water potential. So always the water movement occurs from higher water potential to lower water potential. That is, movement occurs from N to M. Okay, so the same thing they may give in the form of saying that one cell is, let us take M, another cell is, let us take N, right? So what is M here? M is nothing but what? Minus 2000 megapascals. So they may give sometimes in the form of diagram, nothing, two cells, M cell and N cell. Remember, the flow occurs from N to M. Right, that occurs from N to M. Why? Because movement always occurs from higher water potential to lower water potential. Here I repeat again, the logic is the bigger number with the negative sign is a smaller number, and the smaller number with the negative sign itself is the bigger number. So for this question, what is the answer? N to M, that is a higher water potential to lower water potential. Such kind of numerical questions, you have to be cautious, you have to be careful. Even though you know the total story about osmosis and where to where the water movement occurs, but you have to be careful with this kind of confusing aspects. Here these two are confusing things. Most of the students, they get confused with these two, and they get confused with these values, with the negative values. These are the confusing places most of the times in the questions on the paper, right? I hope you understood this. I'll repeat again quickly, right? Now, osmosis we discussed. Now, let us take chamber A with low solute concentration. Very few molecules are there, very few solute molecules are there, then definitely higher is the water potential. Other chamber, the more solute molecules are there, then high solute means lower is the water potential. Now, where to where movement is happening in this case? Now, suppose which chamber or movement? In this case, movement is happening from where to where? Movement of solution, movement of water, definitely from higher solute concentration, high water potential to low water potential. In this case, the movement occurs from A to B. The direction of net movement of osmosis is A to B, because higher water potential to lower water potential. Now, question is, which chamber contains higher water potential means? Remember, it's A having few solute molecules. This you will not confuse, but the confusion arises with these two. Now, high solute potential means also comes same A, because potentiality, solute potential meaning ability to move from one place to other place. More water, less solute molecules means they move very freely to all directions. Potentiality, ability to move in all directions is greater. So, you find solute potential increases for chamber A. Similarly, lower water potential is B, that also shows lower solute potential, that is also B. Why? More solute molecules are there, ability to move will be reduces, that means solute potential decreases. So we write low solute means we have to write B, low water potential also B. With this, what you have to understand, what are the important note points you have to remember? Water potential is directly inversely proportional to solute concentration. Similarly, solute potential is also inversely proportional to solute concentration. That means water potential is directly proportional to solute potential. This is what the final conclusion which you have to remember. For some cases, in some terms, the question will be given logically in terms of minus values. Suppose the question is, the one chamber has water potential minus 2000 megapascals, which is given as cell M. Another chamber, another cell N, has water potential minus 1000 megapascals means, you remember, the minus with great number is the smallest number, the minus with small number is the greatest number. So higher water potential means N will come, that has minus 1000 megapascals, and lower water potential means M will come having minus 2000. So the net movement of water movement, osmotic movement, will occur from N to M. This is nothing but total story called as osmosis. I hope you all followed, right? Yes. Now, let us talk about types of solutions. In lower classes also you studied, probably in chemistry also you will be studied. Now we have the, like the first one is isotonic solution. What is isotonic solution here? This is a cytoplasm. Let us take a plant cell. Let us take a plant cell. Now, if you take the plant cell, what are the two things you find? One is nothing but cell wall. Other, what you find is nothing but cell membrane. Right. Now, so when the concentrations and outer and inner are same, then we say cell is kept in isotonic solution. Then we say cell is kept in isotonic solution. What is the definition we can write with isotonic solution? If it is a living cell is given, if it is a plant cell is given, just note down so clearly here. If external solution balances with, right, so what is the thing we are writing here? We are writing isotonic solution. What is an isotonic solution here? If external solution balances with what it balances? Obviously inside the cell, outside the cell, both are same, right? If external solution balances with osmotic pressure of cytoplasm, osmotic pressure of cytoplasm, then here it's called isotonic solution. What's exactly meaning of this? You find this is the external solution, and here if you talk about OP, what is OP here? Osmotic pressure. OP is nothing but what? Osmotic pressure. If the external solution balances with osmotic pressure of the cytoplasm, external solution balances with the osmotic pressure of the cytoplasm, then it is called as what? Isotonic solution. So as a result, what happens here? Solution is coming out and some solution is going out. How long it happens? Until it reaches what is called equilibrium state. So when isotonic solution means, automatically it refers to what? Cell is in equilibrium state. Some solution is keep on coming, some solution is keep on going out, that means cell is balanced, it got neutralized. Now the cell is no more movement of the solution, cell is said to be in equilibrium state. Isotonic solution refers to equilibrium state. If the cell reaches to equilibrium state, what happens then? So here no net movement of solution. No net movement of solution, or we say net movement of solution will be zero, right? Either you can write no net movement of solution, or we say net movement of solution is zero. That means no our solution is going out, no solution is coming out here, and here it is completely balances. Solution is not moving, so movement is zero. That means cell is in kept in equilibrium state. That is itself is called as what? Isotonic solution. I repeat again, okay, what is that? External solution balances with the osmotic pressure of the cytoplasm. It's said to be isotonic, and that refers to equilibrium state. Movement of solution becomes zero. Similarly, let us talk about other types. Let us take hypotonic solution. Let us talk about hypotonic solution. So when you talk about hypotonic solution, you find high solute concentration. inside you find low solute concentration. That means a plant cell is kept in high solute concentration, itself is called hypertonic solution. Guys, hypertonic, we may talk in terms of water or we may talk in terms of solute. Now, to understand the concept, we are talking in terms of solute concentration. Okay, that means when a plant cell is kept in high solute concentration, for example, this is a plant cell, we took the beaker. Beaker has more solute concentration. Okay, so let us take plant cell called A. Let us take plant cell called A. Now, A is kept in hypertonic. In the question, it is given that A is kept in hypertonic. That means what you have to imagine in your mind? Imagine plant cell called A, and surrounding the plant cell A, you find more solute. More solute means here you find high solute concentration. Whenever you find more, more may be in terms of water or in terms of solute, then you can use the terminology called hyper, right? But mostly we apply for solute concentration. Sometimes outside the cell you find more water. See, in terms of water also it's called hyper, right? But you, according to the question, you have to choose carefully. You should understand the meaning of the question. Most of the times hyper terminology we apply to differentiate what is called high solute concentration and low solute concentration. When a cell A is kept in high solute concentration means outside the cell A you find more solute concentration. It's called hypertonic solution. Right, now obviously you have to understand inside the cell you find low solute concentration, right? Then let us talk about other category called as hypotonic solution. Hypotonic solution, obviously everybody knows the meaning, hyper meaning more. Then what is the meaning of hypo? Hypo means less. So here we say a cell, a plant cell, that is, let us take this is a plant cell. A cell is kept in hypo means less solute concentration. That means outside the cell you find less solute concentration. So obviously it is understood that inside the cell you find high solute concentration. Obviously, right? When a plant cell A is kept in hypo, hypo means less. So let us take this is a beaker. Beaker is having water. Water has very few solute molecules here and there. Then this less solute concentration itself is refers to hypo. Hypo means less. Hyper means more. That may be in terms of water or may be in terms of solute concentration. But mostly we apply for solute concentration. Then this is called as hypotonic solution. I hope you got all three categories very clearly. I repeat again, isotonic everybody knows. But in this case, in water potential, in what you call in the movement of water, in transport of water, you have to remember specific definition for isotonic, especially in terms of plant cell we are speaking. So you need to remember the definition. If excellent solution balances with the osmotic pressure of the cytoplasm, it's said to be isotonic. Isotonic means it's in equilibrium state. Solution is going out and coming out. Then there is after some time when equilibrium reaches, then no need to move outer and inner, everything got stabilized. That means no net movement of solution, or we say net movement of solution becomes zero. Everybody knows this is called isotonic solution. Similarly, coming to hypertonic solution, cell A or plant cell is kept in, cell is kept in high solute concentration. It may be solute or it may be water, but the thing is hyper means more, higher, right? So cell A is kept in hyper means surrounding the cell you find high solute concentration. When you write surrounding the cell high solute means, obviously take it granted that inside the cell it is low solute concentration. Generally students will feel that as if the concept is understood very well, but thing is when it comes to the matter of questions on the question paper, you need to be very very cautious. in understanding whether it is hypo they are speaking about, they are hypo they are speaking about, whether the outside the cell is more solute or inside the cell is low solute. You need to have a clear clarity in your mind. Hyper means cell is kept in hyper means high solute. For example, if the question is given, cell is in hypo, that means inside the cell high solute concentration. Guys, I hope you understood. Cell is kept in hyper means outside the cell you find high solute. Cell is in hyper concentration. Cell is in hyper means inside the cell is hyper. Inside the cell is high solute concentration you have to take. According to the question, you have to carefully move ahead in choosing the option. Most of the times people will confuse here. So I'm stressing down the point. What is the point? Hyper. Cell is kept in hyper. Cell is kept in hyper means outside the cell is more solute. Inside the cell is less solute. Cell is in hyper and inside the cell is more solute. So that is hypotonic solution. Coming to hypo. Hypo to hypotonic means less. Hypotonic means less. Less concentration. Outside the plant cell is you find less solute concentration or less water. Inside the cell you find high solute concentration. Hypo means it talks about less. It may be a solute, it may be a water. So whenever the question is cell is kept in hypo means outside the cell less solute. Sometimes in the question it is given, I hope you all are listening carefully. Sometimes the question will be given, cell is in hypo, cell itself is hypo, not kept, cell itself is hypo. Then you have to take instead of here high, you have to take what? Low solute concentration. Again, I'm telling you, you have to be careful. According to the question, you have to choose the option. Concept is easy. People will feel that, yeah, I know iso, hyper and hypo. But you have to be careful in answering the questions, especially related to transport in plants. Right, guys? We are clear with all three types, no? Iso, hyper and hypo. Why do we discuss all three types of solutions here? Now, here we have a concept which is related to the types of solutions. Now, let us start with the concept here. With these three solutions, if you keep it in your mind, you can understand clearly the concept, right? So, we studied what is called isotonic, hyper and hypo, three solutions we discussed. Now, let us apply the types of solutions for the concept called plasmolysis. What is the concept? Plasmolysis. So plasma membrane, in this what you can see, plasma membrane, it shows some turgidity, it shows what is called flaccidity. That is what we will discuss. So it's called plasmolysis. Plasmolysis, if you take, it's a reversible process. It is a reversible process. What is reversible plasma? Why it is called reversible process? Plasmolyzed cell. What you can see here, plasmolyzed cell can be deplasmolyzed cell. Can be deplasmolyzed cell. It undergoes plasmolysis. If it undergoes plasmolysis, it's called plasmolyzed cell. And after some time, again it will undergo what is called deplasmolyzed cell. That means plasmolysis results in what is called deplasmolysis. Deplasmolysis. So, what is a plasmolyzed cell? Now, if you take, this is a plant cell. I am talking about this is a plant cell. What you can see externally, it's nothing but cell wall. Cell wall is a non-living, strong, rigid layer. Right, it protects the cell. Now, by losing the solution out, here solution is going out, then this becomes what is called placid cell. So, what's the meaning of plasmolyzed cell here? This is protoplast. What is this? This is nothing but protoplast. Protoplast is completely got shrink. Protoplast is completely got shrink. Plasmolyzed cell means it's a placid cell. Remember, plasmolyzed cell means it is a placid cell. So here pressure potential is zero. So water potential is equal to solute potential. Very, very important. So remember, for a plasmolyzed cell, if at all the question is, for a plasmolyzed cell, nothing but placid cell, pressure potential is zero, very very important, and water potential is equivalent to solute potential at standard atmospheric pressure. At standard atmospheric pressure. Remember, we'll discuss this, right? What is deplasmolysis? What is deplasmolysis? It's said to be reversible. Plasmolyzed will become deplasmolyzed cell. Then the entry of solution. Solution enters inside the cell. Now placid cell will become now a fully turgid cell. Now placid cell will become a fully turgid cell. This is a turgid cell. Why? Solution is entering. Then here you can take water potential is equal to solute potential plus pressure potential. Nothing, you have to remember one point, plasmolysis is reversible. That means plasmolysis can become deplasmolysis. Plasmolysis, if it undergo, it's called plasmolyzed cell. What is that? Your solution is going, cell wall is rigid as it is, it's there in its shape and size, but protoplast will get become shrinking, it will become placid cell. Plasmolyzed cell means placid cell, where pressure potential zero, water potential is equal to solute potential at standard atmospheric pressure. Coming to after some time, when solution is added here again back, then placid cell will become turgid cell, it swells, then water potential is equal to solute plus pressure potential. Turgid cell itself is called deplasmolyzed cell, placid cell itself is called plasmolyzed cell.